So the arthrosis is a disease that affects around 5% of the patients that have a fracture, and this fracture cannot heal. This is a problem in medicine because these people undergo surgery, but this fracture never heals, so at the end they can lose the extremity.
Bad lesions such as nonunion fractures create voids that must be filled with ceramic granules, and this will help the regeneration of the bone because these materials are said to be osteoconductive. So we have developed an injectable hydrogel that we mix with components that are signals for cells to proliferate, to differentiate into specialized osteoblasts. We are incorporating in our formulations nanoparticles, which hold osteoinductive molecules and release them over time to make this material become more effective in terms of regeneration. We are developing particles with the ability to release an antibiotic, gentamicin, in a controlled way over a fairly long period of time, in the order of 4 weeks, to control potential infections. We're using proteins from extracellular matrix. This has been exploited as a technology to regenerate different tissues. Also, we're working with statins, which are a family of molecules which induce bone regeneration.
Vascularization is the bottleneck for regenerative medicine. A lot of tissues cannot regenerate because of the lack of vascularization. So we are trying to develop new biomaterials that can degrade and can release different ions, and these ions can stimulate vascularization. Right now, we have developed a couple of biomaterials that we have demonstrated that they can stimulate the growth of new vessels in the damaged tissue. These biomaterials that we are working with are calcium phosphate glasses. These glasses are bioactive. Results obtained till now are fibers with nanoparticles of bioactive glasses that we can control very finely the release of the ions. That means that we can obtain a certain concentrations at the site of the injury where we can implant biomaterials that can make the cells from the body to migrate to the site of the injury and to start to produce the new tissue. This has been demonstrated in vitro and also in small animals like rats and mice.
We've been developing these formulations for about 3 years now. This included a number of preclinical trials in small animals, then larger animals. And given the promising results obtained, we are in collaboration with a hospital planning clinical trials.
We are in the point to go to preclinical studies. We need these preclinical studies in order to demonstrate the efficacy and efficiency of these biomaterials, and then we can go directly to clinical studies with patients.
Over 100,000 million people in Europe suffer from degenerative disease of the musculoskeletal system, like osteoporosis, arthritis. Only osteoporosis are about 50 million in Europe.
It's a general disease that is affecting our bone strength, and that occurs mainly above 60 years of age. And people that are affected have weak bone and are prone to fracture. When you have a fracture in an osteoporotic bone, it's very difficult to heal and to stabilize this fracture with the present technique, which mainly use plate or screw or nail. The alternative to improve the osteoporotic status of the patient is to have systemic drugs.
So the idea is to develop gel-like structures like slices, then cover with nanofibers. And these fibers could carry some positional cues. They could be random or aligned or other orientation. And then we put stem cells. And depending on the cues which they instruct the cells, we expect a different way of differentiation.
The main focus of this consortium is to develop nano regenerative composite carrying drug or ion, mainly strontium, that could regenerate bone and improve the strength of the bone. And this nanoparticle of hydroxyapatite, the main component of bone containing this ion strontium, are dispersed in a hydrogel who has the main composite. When injected in the body, it will solidify and fill all the empty space.
Our nanofibers are about 200 nanometers in diameter, and they carry material like polyol, which is have a very good viscoelastic properties, but they carry also fibrinogen, which the cells recognize very well. They like, they love this protein. And what is important, it is not toxic.
We are now looking the best concentration of nanoparticle will be then used in vitro, and the best composite will then go to be tested in the animal model.
We show that we have cartilage, we show that we have bone. Actually, we already implanted chondrogenic construct. We prove this in animal studies and expecting be osteochondral implants.